Hey! Don.
Nadia.
Good to see you again.
Good to see you.
You have a new movie for me.
I do. It's Catch Me If You Can meets Home Alone.
Oh, okay.
So we're starting with Kevin McAbacus. He's a normal suburban kid. He's reading comic books. He's thinking of MacGyver-esque ways to adorably harm other people. But his whole life comes crashing down. He loses his house, his parents get divorced, and they split up.
It's over!
They leave him. Guess what? Kevin is all alone.
And is he like, ah!
Maybe. He might be like, no!
Stop!
Don't go!
Fists instead of flat hands.
Maybe he's just like this.
Claws.
Mm-hmm. And like all kids of divorce, he thinks it's his fault. So he's like, sure. I need to get my house back. And if I get my house back, I get my family back together.
Is this like a family film or?
It's rated G.
That's great.
Rated G for kids.
For kids?
Good kids.
Keep going.
Kevin's down at the bank because that's where money is. He sees a pilot walk through the door. He's getting treated like a king. He's signing like 50 checks. Bank tellers are giving him suitcases full of cash. So Kevin's like, that's it. I need to become a fake pilot so I can write fake checks and get my house back. Plot. Plot.
Do you just keep saying plot so I know that?
Plot time. So he does it. He becomes a fake pilot. He starts forging checks and he starts accumulating money. But guess who gets a whiff of this illegal activity? The FBI, the check fraud division. And that's led by the bumbling duo of agents Gary and Merv. They track Kevin down to this motel and they talk to the manager. And the manager's like, yeah, he's been living in room 201. But guess who overhears this? Kevin. He's always in the right place at the right time. He rushes back to his room. He puts on a Christmas album. And then he has this, like, silhouette party. And Merv and Gary, they're self-conscious. We can't go in there, right? We look like crap.
This outfit's too dirty.
Okay, so let's wait in the van. The party will die down. And then we'll get him. Fall asleep. Party's over. Kevin split. I should say, by the way, his mother's been trying to find him this whole time.
Oh.
They came back like 10 seconds after they got divorced. They go, where'd the kid go? Where's my Kevy boy? His mother joins a polka band that's touring the country to go look for Kevin.
Everybody loves polka.
Now, Kevin knows they have to drop the pilot thing, so he becomes a fake doctor. Merv and Gary, they track him down to the hospital. They hatch this plan that's too loud because Kevin's right there listening to it. Oh, they're coming back? Time to protect my checks. Nighttime rolls around. Merv and Gary roll in their undercover, really bad van. They get out, the coast is clear. They go to the side door, they go to the exit door. They're about to open the door, they both slip on some ice.
Booby traps.
Booby traps. Merv hits his head, throws up everywhere, he's got a concussion. Gary tries to get up, he's got a bruised butt. He touches the door handle, he gets zapped backwards because there's a defibrillator on the other side. And then we see Kevin peek his head out, and then he moons them. How much crack can we get away with in a G movie?
Not too much.
So, now they're inside. Out of nowhere, a bunch of paint cans fall on them. Someone just flies in that's in mid-surgery and hits them into two wheelchairs. The wheelchairs start rolling down the hallway. Plasma bags right in their face. Cotton balls right in their face. The wheelchair hits a severed limb, and Merv and Gary go flying into a used pile of hypodermic needles. Right down. Kevin walks over and goes, keep the money, you filthy beasts. And that's the end of the movie. No, it's not. We cut back. Kevin's at home with his parents. They're all hugging. They're back together. And then the FBI shows up. Kevin's like, hey, mom and dad, this is what I did. And his parents are like, oh, that was horrible.
Take him away.
Then we cut to the jail. A voiceover goes, Kevin McAbacus was sentenced to 400 years in prison because he made a mess.
I think this movie's gonna work.
Ooh!
I don't know why we just did that, but I like it.